Hi folks, CloudShots here with another potato cam video featuring the Apple IIe system. This time with the Apple CD-ROM Explorer disc that shipped with the 1988 released Apple CD-SC. And this disc features a couple slideshow presentations, both HyperCard for the Mac and just some mixed media types for the 2GS and 2E. And we're going to focus on the 2E presentation here. So with most of the content being created in what looks like 1987, I imagine there was still maybe a lot of consumer question of what a CD-ROM could be used for, so this presentation was kind of an attempt to answer those types of questions with nice pictures and sounds in some cases. So I'll just focus on a couple sections here that feature the additional sound. And I'll do some narration along the way here. Imagine the not so serious side of things too. As CD-ROM discs become more popular, you're likely to see captivating new forms of books, games, and entertainment begin to appear. A CD-ROM disc could contain an entire novel, complete with illustrations, animation, and sound. At strategic points, you interact with the story and change its course. The story is different every time you read it. Here's our fictional game Dragon Snare. CD-ROM discs could be used for interactive action and adventure games using more graphics and sound. You might even make up your own games and interactive stories by using clip art graphics and sounds. So here's the fictional CD-ROM Adventure Maker. Imagine the ultimate trivia game on a CD-ROM disc. It could combine all the trivia games now published at a variety of skill levels. You'd choose your trivia category from a subject selection menu. Then you choose the level of difficulty. A question would appear on the screen and you'd choose your answer. There are plenty of serious practical uses for CD-ROM, but there's also great potential on the not-so-serious side of things too. Watch for new entertainment applications using more sound and graphics on CD-ROM. Imagine the possibilities for using sound. CD-ROM offers full digital sound capability, opening up a multitude of creative and practical possibilities. A disc on ornithology might contain not only text and pictures, but also bird songs. Adventure games could take on a new dimension with a variety of sound effects and animated graphics. And the worst looking dinosaur I've ever seen. It's ridiculous. Anyway. A CD-ROM disc could help you learn sight reading and pitch memory. Libraries of digitized sound samples on CD-ROM can be used by musicians to create new music and sound effects for their electronic synthesizers. Wife's chastising the kids in the background. This is real life. So that's skipped. I'm going to have to skip ahead. only because when the tracks skip like that, it jumps to the next sound sample. So pretend that never happened and that I didn't read that, because I didn't. For example, a disc on Tchaikovsky could not only tell you about his life and times, but also let you hear examples from his compositions. I think this screen's kind of cool here. You might want to study the Nutcracker Ballet Suite. And they kind of give a little graphical representation of how you'd navigate the menu and everything, so it's not functional, of course. You can follow the score as you listen to the music. Sound takes up a lot of space on computer discs. With the space available on CD-ROM, sound can be used as a part of many different computer applications. So those were just two examples given here. They also go through some library use cases and some additional like educational type possibilities as well. So I'm going to jump down to the audio CD sampler section. And we'll play the whole introduction here.
Computers could only make a few sounds before now. That's because sound can take up a lot of disk space. With CD-ROM, computers can use sound to help teach, prompt, alert, praise, answer, and excite users. Sa dove è Voices can teach foreign languages.
Entschuldigen Sie bitte. Wo ist der Bahnhof?
Music can be appreciated. Or set a mood. Sound effects can provide interactive feedback. Or help create an environment. More than 1 hour of high-quality stereo sound can be stored on a single CD-ROM. And at lower levels of sound quality, even greater amounts of sound can be stored. And when you're not using your Apple CDSC to access information, you can use it to play your audio compact discs. The music samples on the menu demonstrate the audio capability of the Apple CDSC.
Check out this piece of 80s rock. That reminds me of Tangerine Dreams, either The Optical Race or Lily on the Beach, same time frame that those were composed in. So there you go. There were a couple other things here. There's a couple like demonstration programs or some public domain stuff, and this book brain, which seems kind of useless in my opinion. House Call, which is a like a CD-ROM medical reference. You know, you type in your symptoms, and it would give you different Mayo Clinic type responses and everything. So there you go. This is kind of cool. And again, it kind of showed some of the possibilities. I'm really surprised they went to this much detail and, you know, this much effort was taken with the Apple IIe presentation, given that that capability was never really leveraged with this system to the extent that it could have been. So there you have it.